What do you think of this land of Judea?
Oh, it's charming. As well as dry and hot. But you know, dear, it was never the land that impressed me.
But then why did you beg me to bring you here?
For the people, my love. Just look at them.
Yes, I am looking at them. I see nothing special here. Nothing greater than the people of Rome.
Well, then look closely. Because I see resilience in them. Can you not see the hope, the faith that these people have?
Faith? The Romans have thousands of gods. How can you have more faith than to believe in 1,000 gods?
That's easy. To have only one. And to continually depend upon that god for all deliverance.
Deliverance. Well, they surely have been delivered quite a lot lately.
Shall we talk history?
We shall talk history,
I
yes.
I hope so.
These are a people who have gotten themselves conquered by more captors than I care to keep straight. Mm. Their kings are at best... problematic. Mm. Claudia, you and I have seen these people. They do not keep their own God's commandments. And they certainly cannot keep their own land. Roman rule. It's finally brought some semblance of order to this forsaken land.
And I suppose you believe you could do a much better job at governing these people.
Oh, but Claudia, what man would come all this way only to please his wife?
Marcus Pontius Pilate, a man who loves his wife, that's who.
Yes, a man who loves his wife, and would see her in a position of power and prestige which she deserves.
Ever the politician.
Claudia, I promise you that one day I will provide for you the life that commands the respect that a granddaughter of Caesar deserves. And if you love these people, then so do I. Ah, yes. This is why we have come to the temple today. We are to meet with the high priest.
Hail Caesar.
Hail Caesar.
Marcus Pontius Pilate, an honor. May I present Joseph, son of Caiaphas, high priest appointed by the Roman procurator, Valerius Gratus.
Dear Pontius Pilate.
Caiaphas.
Your reputation precedes you. Welcome, honored guests, to Jerusalem. What brings you so far from Rome?
Oh, well, Caiaphas, it is my wisdom that has brought me here. And by my wisdom, I do mean my bride. May I present Claudia, my wife. She insists that we visit. We are on our honeymoon, after all.
As beautiful as she is wise, may she always point you in the right direction. Come, Pilate, I believe we have much to discuss.
Surely, nothing of much importance. I am but a tourist here, at the whim of my wife's happiness.
Even tourists can have ambitions.
Well, then, I have been shown off. My duty here is done.
Milady, your duty has just begun. Shouldn't you be joining them?
No. They care not for my opinions now. Now all they care for is power.
Oh, Milady, please be careful how you speak of the High Priest. He is a very religious man and has great influence.
Miriam, speak honestly with me. Would that man be just as devout if he did not have the highest position in this province? Under Rome, of course.
It is not my place to say.
He would not. I know plenty of men of his rank in society. I tell you, a man who has held a position as high as him for as long as he has no novice traits.
Milady, please, if someone should hear you.
Does he serve his God? Or does serving his God serve his agenda? Why do I even ask you? Where is Sarah? At least she will not be afraid to give me an honest answer. Sarah?
My lady.
Where have you been?
Oh, my lady, you'd be amazed to hear what I just heard.
You had best explain yourself.
That boy over there by the temple? One would be amazed to hear what wisdom and teaching could come from one so young. Even the priests were amazed to hear him speak.
Really? He must be one impressive young man.
His name is Jesus of Nazareth. He's the son of a carpenter, and he can't be more than 12 years old.
Well, then, I have time. Show me to him. I wish to listen for myself to one so young, rather than the hypocrisy of powerful men. Miriam, you stay with Pilate. If they happen to ask for my opinion, tell them I never thought they would, so I left.
Oh, m'lady, I can't say that.
Oh, I know that you wouldn't. I would. You must find some excuse and come find me.
Come. Cover your head and follow me.
So you see, Pilate, I do not wish to create conflict between our people and Rome. We have our religious laws to follow, and if allowed to follow those laws, there will be very little need for Rome to enforce their own.
Yes, your laws. But they are limited, are they not?
You see, this is where our mutual cooperation becomes so vital. Yes, there are some limitations where we would need Roman approval to proceed.
Like exacting punishment by law?
Surely, by the time we have tried a criminal in our courts and found them guilty by our laws, there will be no doubt as to how you should proceed.
I see.
Jesus! Oh, there you are! My goodness!
Here you are. Jesus! We left immediately after the festival. We thought you were through our relatives and our friends.
We traveled a whole day before we realized you were not with us.
We returned immediately to look for you.
My son, why have you treated us like this? Your father and I have been anxiously searching for you.
Why were you searching for me? Didn't you know I had to be in my father's house?
Marcus, you would not believe what I have just heard.
Claudia, you would not believe what I have just heard. A religious leader under occupation who only wants peace.
What? Him? Of course he wants peace, Marcus. If he keeps the peace, he keeps his position. No, I was talking about a young man over here I'd like you to hear. Oh, it seems they've left already. Never mind, I will send Sarah after him.
Please, do not send that poor girl after some little boy. What on earth are you talking about?
The question, my dear husband, is not what I was talking about, but rather what he was talking about.
Yes, I see. Please, go on. For I know that if I do not listen now, I will be hearing about it for ages.
Thank you. It was a boy, speaking in the temple as though he were a man. He's nothing but the son of a carpenter from Nazareth, and yet...
That's slum.
Marcus, try to listen. I tell you, I have had to listen to many men in my day, and this one...
Oh, I'm sorry. You, listen.
Very funny. I have had to listen to many men in my day, and never have I heard one teach with more wisdom or understanding. I couldn't help but be amazed.
Claudia, please.
How could you think this was a good idea?
Do not criticize me. It has been my thoughts and my ideas and my hard work that has gotten us this far. Is this not what you wanted? What we wanted? I got myself appointed governor over all of Judea, and I made you the most respected woman in this province. So please, do not question my judgment.
I do not criticize your judgment, husband. You are an experienced governor, and you have achieved much, for you are diligent and sensible, and I happen to love you for it. I only wish to appeal to your sense of reason.
If you want to speak of reason, then speak of the Jews and their lack of it. Is it not reasonable to display images of your emperor?
Well,
is it not his face that should be on their coin? They are a captive people. They should be grateful that we have not enslaved them.
Dear, no people are grateful to be occupied, but you have shown them great compassion and clemency as their governor. It's just...
Go on, get on with
it. It's just that they are not Romans. You cannot expect that they would act as such.
Are they not under the Roman Empire?
They are, but they are Jews under the Roman Empire, and they are best behaved when you let them act Jewish.
That makes no sense. How is honoring Caesar against being Jewish?
Because we Romans have many gods, including Caesar.
Yes, I too was raised in Rome, was I not?
And you still don't get it. Husband, they have one God. You cannot expect them to worship Caesar without asking them to go against the first and most important religious rule.
Well, what rule is this?
Oh, thou shalt have no other gods before me. It's only the first of the Ten Commandments.
Now you're trying to tell me they only have 10 commandments?
They have hundreds of laws after that.
Yep.
But there are 10 that are especially sacred.
Then I will abolish their laws.
You cannot.
How can I govern a people who insist on governing themselves under this guise of religion?
It's not a
no,
guise.
No, no. This is an act of rebellion, and I will treat it as such. Guard. Guard. Force. That is how you put down a rebellion.
My lord.
Husband. I fear that you are too quick to shed the blood of innocent people. Please have mercy on them. If you show them that you are a benevolent leader, they will love you for it and obey. The Jews have many stories of those who try to use force to make them worship other gods. It did not go well for them. Apparently, this god stands up for his own. There are stories of men who were thrown into fiery furnaces who were not burned. Stories of men thrown into lions' dens, and somehow the lion's mouth stayed shut.
What is this nonsense of furnaces and lions?
The god of the Jews is a jealous god, Marcus. I am warning you. I beg you. We are the ones in authority here. For our sake, please, do not go against him.
What is it?
The high priest is requesting an audience with you. He comes with many followers.
Please speak with him. There may not be need for any bloodshed tonight.
See him in. Only him. The others can wait outside. Fine. You may stay. But you will not interfere.
Understood.
Pilate?
Caiaphas.
Would it not be better to discuss this very delicate matter alone?
Just as your Eve was taken from a rib of Adam, I too am a part of my husband's side, and I will not leave it.
Dearest Governor, I can only see two outcomes for tonight. In the One, you will be responsible for keeping the peace and paying homage to our great Caesar. In the Other, you will be responsible for causing the greatest bloodshed the Empire has ever seen, which will result in you losing your position of governor of Judea because there will be no Judea left to govern. We require that you remove your images of Caesar and remove his image from our coins. If you do not comply...
Then what? Will you fight? With what army will you defend yourselves?
No, we will not fight. Each of the 12 tribes have agreed that if you do not comply, we will shed our own blood in numbers so great.
Marcus.
That there will be no tribe of Judea left to govern, let alone 12. You'll be responsible for the annihilation of your entire province, and you'll have the wrath of Caesar for it.
Caiaphas, you forget your place. I may not have appointed you, but I have the power to take that position away.
If you do not relent, there will be nobody to take my place.
In respect of your 10 commandments, we will take down the images of Caesar. But you are a captive people who owe much to the Empire. His face will remain on your coins. Agreed?
Agreed.
And Caiaphas, if even one man takes his life in the name of your God, he will be left in the streets to be eaten by dogs, and his family will be destroyed. Woman, are you a Roman or are you a Jew?
I am your wife, Marcus.
You are my wife. And you are a granddaughter of Caesar. Yet I see you siding with these Jews. Are you two against me?
I am not against you. I only spoke up to help you understand their religion. I have worshipped the Roman gods since my childhood. And I don't think my prayers change anything. The way I see it, either the Roman gods just play with our fate, or it's all just a bunch of empty tradition. Since you question my allegiance, allow me to tell you exactly where I stand. I am loyal to Caesar, but Roman worship does nothing for me. There is something about these Jews and about their God that speaks to me.
Will you rebel against me too, then?
I will speak what I know to be true.
It's here. We've made it. We've made it to the sea. Oh, what a glorious sight. And what is that heavenly smell?
It's fresh air, you silly woman. I almost forgot the smell myself.
Sarah, it is just as glorious as you described it in your tales.
My father fished this sea his whole life, and his father before him.
Hush, lest you remind our mistress that it is not becoming to have a fisherman's daughter as a handmaiden.
I have never forgotten, and I never minded. Who else would have the patience to answer all of my questions of your god and your people? Certainly not Miriam.
Oh, mistress, you are a Roman. I am your servant. It is not my place to.
Miriam, I only jest with you.
My lady, a multitude of people is approaching. It is not safe for a lady to be here.
Why ever would a multitude approach me here?
Mistress, if I may.
Please.
I believe that is the teacher I've heard of. He teaches with great wisdom, and multitudes from all over Judea come just to hear him speak. Some say that he may be the, you know...
Sarah, do not bother our mistress with such rumors.
She is not a bother. Go on, Sarah. What do the Jews say of this teacher?
Well, they say that, well, that he may be the Messiah. The one long ago foretold to deliver all of Israel.
You speak of the promised one.
One to cause trouble for our people. Sarah, have you forgotten who our mistress's husband is? Do you want to get this teacher killed? Mistress, he is just a Nazarene, no one of consequence. At best, he's a son of a carpenter. At worst, he's a bastard and a troublemaker.
He is not.
Enough. I shall be free to form my own opinion of this rabbi. Sarah, prepare my shawl. Guards, stand back and do not give me away. This multitude cares only to listen to this man, and so do I. They will never notice one more.
Behold, a sower went forth to sow, and when he sowed, some seeds fell by the wayside, and the fowls of the earth came and devoured them up. Some seeds fell upon the rocky places, where they had not much earth, and immediately they sprung up. But when the sun was in the sky, they were scorched, and because they had no root, they withered away. Other seeds fell upon the thorny places, and the thorns sprung up and choked them, making them unfruitful. But some seeds fell upon the good soil, and these seeds produced a crop, yielding 100, 60, or even 30 times that which was sown. He who has ears, let him hear.
Why do you speak to the people in parables?
Because the knowledge of the secrets of the kingdom of heaven have been given to you, but not to them. Whoever has will be given more, and they will have an abundance. But to whoever who does not have, even what little they have will be taken away from them. This is why I speak to them in parables.
I know this man. I have heard him teach before. He was not a man when I heard him last.
Listen then to what the parable of the sower means. When someone hears the word, but does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away that which was sown in their heart. This is the seed sown along the path. The seed sown among the rocky places refers to someone who hears the word and receives it with joy. But when trouble or persecution come because of the word, they quickly fall and wither away because they have no root. The seed sown among the thorny places refers to someone who hears the word, but the worries of this life and deceitfulness of wealth choke the word and make it unfruitful. But the seed sown on the good soil refers to someone who hears the word and understands it. They are the ones who produce a crop yielding 100, 60, or even 30 times that which was sown.
I am no Jew, yet I feel as though I understand him.
Send the crowd away, so they can go to the surrounding villages and countryside and find food and lodging, because we're in a remote place here. It's going to take more than half a year's wages to buy enough bread for them to even have one bite.
Here is a boy with 5 small barley loaves and 2 small fish, but surely how will they go among so many, teacher?
Have the people sit down. Abba, we thank you for this boy and for his willingness to share his 5 loaves and 2 fish with us. Abba, bless this food and all those who taste it, that they would taste and see that the Lord is good. Go and distribute to all. Tell them to take as much as they want.
There are 5,000 people here alone.
In their hearts. Miriam, is your heart so hard?
Messiah? Our people have been waiting a long time, and every generation believed that they would be the ones to be delivered. How can you have hope whenever you see a man from the lineage of King David? How many generations have prayed to be delivered, have prayed for the promised one? How can you still believe? And how can you not fear that this one would just raise up our hopes to have him crushed?
Because our God is the God of miracles. And he is here, moving in our midst. Let faith arise. In spite of what I see, Lord, I believe. But help my unbelief, I choose to trust you. No matter what I feel, let faith arise. God love, miracles come. Impossible.
shouldn't be here. It is not safe for a Roman, let alone a Roman woman of your stature.
Nonsense. Who is to tell I am Roman?
Oh, mistress, at least let me call back your personal guard.
Nothing would proclaim my status more than to be escorted by my personal Roman guard. Please, I do not wish for all of Galilee to acknowledge my presence.
Teacher, we know that you are a man of integrity, and that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth, yes? You are not swayed by others because you pay no mind to who they are. Well, tell us then, what is your opinion? Is it right to pay the imperial tax to Caesar or not?
You hypocrites. Why are you trying to trap me? Show me the coin used for paying the tax. Whose image is on this, and whose inscription?
Caesar's.
So then give back to Caesar what is Caesar's, and give back to God what is God's.
This man is no threat. Did you hear him? A revolutionary would never submit to captivity, let alone encourage others to pay taxes to the empire. I tell you, he is no threat.
But then what does he want? How can you claim to be the king of the Jews and submit to Caesar?
I don't know.
I've heard him speak before. He does not speak of a kingdom here on earth, but of one in heaven.
I have a question, teacher. Which one would you say is the greatest commandment in the law?
Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest of all commandments. And the second is much like it. Love your neighbor as yourself. All the law and the prophets hang on these two commandments.
Huh. Fair enough. I have another question. Whose son is the Messiah?
What do you think of the Messiah? Whose son is he?
I don't know.
The son of David.
How is it then that David, speaking by the Spirit, calls him Lord? For he says, "The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I put your enemies under your feet." If then David calls him Lord, how can he be his son?
Pilate must hear this man. He would know in an instant that he speaks the truth. This man does not use his faith for power or personal gain as those hypocrites over there do.
Oh no, mistress, please, I beg you, do not bring this man to the attention of Pilate. He will only cause heartache for our people. You heard him. He claimed to be the Messiah.
How can he be? You know, you have tasted the bread that he multiplied. What if he is the Messiah?
If he is the Messiah, then there is no way that Pilate nor the religious leaders like Caiaphas would let him live to see his kingdom.
Me, please have mercy, just 2 mites so that I can eat. Have mercy, please have mercy. I was born blind. Please have mercy. Thank you. Bless you, child. Thank you. Mercy, please.
Now, Claudia, I must confess, this stroll through the marketplace is not purely for the pleasure of your company.
Marcus, truly, what must you see now? Matters of the state so dire that we cannot have one uninterrupted outing?
This is the life that we have chosen, Claudia.
but I had hoped to show you the rabbi I've been telling you about. He's rumored to be here.
I would not interrupt our time if it were not for someone of great importance.
Is it Caiaphas?
Yes.
Every single time.
Claudia. He is the high priest of the Jews and their most powerful leader.
Mm-hmm.
It might do you well to remember that. Besides, he's a moderate, and we've always been able to reach peaceful resolutions in the past.
He would not be so moderate if it did not afford him great power. That man's love and friendship will last only as long as it benefits him to be friendly. Do not mistake him for an honest advisor.
Caiaphas!
Pilate. Claudia. Come, Pilate, there are many things we must talk about.
Master, who sinned? This man or his parents, or he was born blind?
Neither this man nor his parents sinned, but this man was born blind, so that the works of God might be displayed in him. As long as it is day, we must do the will of him who sent me. Night is coming when no one can work. While I am in this world, I am the light of the world.
Marcus, it is he, the great rabbi I've been telling you about. Come, you must hear him teach.
Claudia, please. I have matters of state to attend to. I don't have time to sit at the feet and listen to some teacher, no matter how great.
Oh.
Go and wash in the pool of Siloam.
Marcus, you would not believe what the rabbi just did. I know something amazing will happen. I don't want you to miss it.
Excuse me. Claudia, please. Perhaps you have forgotten, but I am Marcus Pontius Pilate, governor over all of Judea and Syria, and I answer to nobody save Caesar. Now you are my wife, whom I love and respect, but I will not be seen as a ruler who is ruled by his wife. Now please, I have business to attend to. Stay and enjoy the marketplace. Guard, see to it that she is well looked after.
I can see. Praise the Son of David. I can see. I'm healed. I can see. Praise the Son of David. I can see.
Wait. Isn't that the same man that used to sit and beg?
No, it only looks like him.
I'm the man.
How then were your eyes opened?
The man they called Jesus. He made some mud. He put it on my eyes and I washed and now I see.
Where is this man?
I don't know.
This man has been blind since, but now he claims that the man they called Jesus healed him.
Well, son, tell me, how is it that you received your sight?
He made some mud, he put it on my eyes, and I washed, and now I see.
Today? On the Sabbath?
Well, yes.
This man is not of God. He does not keep the Sabbath. We know that.
But how could a sinner perform such miracles? What have you to say about him? It was your eyes he opened.
He's a prophet.
Hey, look, I see his parents. Is this your son? The one who was born blind? How is it now that he sees?
Mother.
Oh.
Mother.
Father?
Father.
Well, we know that he is our son. And we know that he was born blind. But how he can see now, or who opened his eyes, we don't know. Ask him. He will speak for himself.
Listen. Let's give glory to God here by telling the truth. We all know this man Jesus is a sinner.
Whether he's a sinner or not, I don't know. One thing I do know. I was blind, but now I see.
Then tell me, how did you do it? How did you open your eyes?
I have told you already. Why do you want to hear it again? Don't you want to become his disciples too?
You are this fellow's disciple. We are disciples of Moses. We know God spoke to Moses. As for this fellow, we don't even know where he comes from.
Now, that is remarkable. You don't know where he comes from, but yet he opened my eyes. We know that God does not listen to sinners. He listens to the godly person who is doing his will. If this man was not from God, he could do nothing.
You were steeped in sin at birth. How dare you lecture us!
Oh. Do you believe in the Son of Man?
Who is he, sir? Tell me so that I may believe.
You have seen him. In fact, he is the one speaking with you.
Lord, I believe.
For judgment I have come into this world, so that the blind will see, and those who see will become blind.
We are blind too?
If you were blind, you would not be guilty of your sin. But now that you claim that you can see, your guilt remains. Come.
My dear, you look lovely.
As the wife of such a powerful man should.
Is the food prepared and ready?
It is.
Good. I have much to discuss with Caiaphas and the Pharisees.
As you should.
Do not be cross with me. Claudia, I have always needed you by my side, as I will need you here tonight. The gods know I could have left you in Rome like the other governors leave their wives. But then who would be honest with me?
Marcus, I fear you may need me more than ever. I do not trust Caiaphas.
And I trust no one but you.
Then I can tell you something. Do you remember the other day there was someone I wanted you to meet? The rabbi I've been telling you about?
Yes, vaguely. What about him?
I watched him perform a miracle.
A miracle? What do you mean?
There was a blind man begging, and this rabbi spit in the dirt and made mud and put it on his eyes. And then he told him to go wash in a certain pool. When that man came back, he could see.
Curious.
Everyone was so happy for him. But you know, the Pharisees were not. I heard a Pharisee call this rabbi a sinner because he chose to heal a man on the day of rest. Marcus, I wish you would not counsel with the Pharisees, but rather speak to this rabbi instead. You would know he speaks the truth, as you know I do.
Claudia, until I have found just cause to dispose of Caiaphas as high priest, it is he I must counsel with.
I see.
Welcome. We have much to discuss, but first, let us eat.
You are a gracious host, but I'm afraid our business cannot wait.
Is there some trouble brewing?
There's a false teacher. A Jew of no consequence. A Nazarene and a bastard at that. Yet he has riled the people, deceiving as he goes, claiming to be the Son of God, the Messiah.
Surely, the ramings of a madman can wait until after we have eaten. Please.
Unfortunately, this is no light matter. He has bewitched the people by his false teaching and sorcery. Yesterday, he entered Jerusalem, riding only on a humble donkey. Many people took off their cloaks and laid them on the road for him to ride on. Other people cut down branches in the fields. Those who went before and those who came behind, they shouted, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Most shockingly, blessed is the coming kingdom of our father David." They carried on until they entered Jerusalem and then into the temple courts.
Claudia, this could not be the rabbi that you've been telling me about, could it?
I believe it is. But I would not even know him by the way that this man has described him.
This man is a revolutionary. He is coaxing the people to go against the Roman leaders and the religious leaders.
He is no such thing. I have heard him tell the people to submit their taxes to Rome.
He calls himself a king. Kings do not submit. He calls himself the Messiah, sent here to deliver his people. Who do you think he will deliver them from other than the Roman occupiers?
I have never heard him usher a word against Rome. But I have heard him speak against you. He has called you hypocrites and a vicious pack of vipers.
Claudia, you forget your place. Caiaphas, what law of Rome has this man broken?
He has no respect for the temple or its leaders. He is causing dissension among the people.
And Roman law prohibits him from neither of these things.
He will be tried by our religious laws and found guilty by our religious courts.
Until he has broken a law of the empire, he is no concern of mine. You may act within your laws, but do not forget its limitations. Now please, my wife has prepared a feast for us, and we have many more pressing matters to discuss. For interest, you might be interested to know that we have captured the murderer Barabbas, and he has been tried and convicted. He soon will hang on a Roman cross for his sins.
Welcome news. Please excuse me. I will be there momentarily. Find this Jesus of Nazareth. Have him arrested soon. But do it before, not during the Passover. It might cause a riot among the people. Leave Pilate to me. He will soon see the need for us to get rid of this Jesus of Nazareth.
You there, state your business or be gone.
Most honorable high priest, I know of this man, Jesus of Nazareth, and where you may find him. What are you willing to give me if I deliver him over to you? I will watch for an opportunity to hand him over.
Before Passover.
Truly, I say to you, this very night, one of you will betray me. The one who has dipped his hand into the bowl will betray me. The Son of Man will go just as it is written about him. But woe to the man who would betray the Son of Man. It would be better for him if he had not been born at all.
Surely you don't mean me, Rabbi.
You have said so. What you are about to do, go and do it quickly. Abba, we give you thanks for the bread. Take and eat. This is my body, broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Abba, we give you thanks for the cup. Take and drink. This is my blood poured out for you, the blood of the new covenant poured out for the forgiveness of your sins. I tell you, I will not drink from the fruit of this vine from now on until that day when I drink it again with you in my Father's kingdom. Do this in remembrance of me. Come, let us go to the Mount of Olives, and we shall pray. John, James, come with me. Wait here. Watch with me. Pray with me. Pray with me. Father. Abba, Father. What is this cup, Father? Must I drink from this? The weight, Father. It's stifling. How do I carry this, Father? Yes, Father. Let your will be done. Let your will be done, Father. Could none of you stay awake with me at this time? Get up! Get up! Your spirits are willing. Don't give in to your flesh. Watch with me. Pray with me. Pray with me. Father. Abba, Father. The cross, Father. It must be lifted up. Yes, Father. Let your will be done. Let your will be done, Father. Abba, Father. Yes, Father. The work. The work. The work must be finished. Yes, Father. Let your will be done. Let your will be done. I take the cup, Father. I take the cup. Yes, Father. Let your will be done. Not my will. Not my will, Father. Let your will be done. Let your will be done.
Enough sleep. Get up. Get up. The dark hour is here. Is this how you give me up? With a kiss? Who are you looking for?
We're looking for the Nazarene, the one called Jesus.
I am. Who is it that you seek again?
We're looking for Jesus of Nazareth. Where is he?
I said it before. I am the one. What use have you for these others? Let them go free.
Rabbi, we will fight. The sword. Stop to use it.
Stop. Ah, stop. Stop. Put away the sword. Put away the sword. This fight is not for now. Legions of angels stand ready. But this is not their hour. This cup is from the Father. Shall I avoid drinking it? No. His will be done.
Rabbi, he healed me.
What is this? Swords, torches, and clubs? I was at the temple every day. Why did you not seize me there? Now is your hour, however. Do what you were sent to do. I am in your hands now.
My lord.
What?
The temple priests have a high news for you.
No. This early in the morning. Isn't this their holy time? Passover? Shouldn't they be tending to their lambs?
Yes, sir. They claim to have a prisoner in custody. One Jesus of Nazareth.
Jesus of Nazareth. Didn't we just capture that murderer, Barabbas? They've got someone else now?
Yes, sir. Barabbas gets the nails this afternoon.
That's good news, at least. We'll be glad to be rid of that one. Now we have this Jesus to deal with. All right, let's get down to Gabbatha. Perhaps we can settle this before breakfast.
Thank you.
Jesus of Nazareth. What did you come to do? Who are you? Why do thoughts of you rule my head and fill my dreams? Guard. Where is my husband?
He was summoned to Gabbatha. They claim to have a prisoner in custody. One Jesus of Nazareth.
Jesus.
Yes, my lady.
Come quickly. You will take a message to my husband and deliver it to him at once. Marcus, have nothing to do with Jesus, that just and innocent man. I have had a dream about him. Please, whatever you do, be wise in dealing with Jesus of Nazareth. That's it. Be swift. He must see this right away. Sarah! Miriam, come quickly. I must get dressed. Oh, will you hurry? We must get to Gabbatha.
People astray by telling them not to pay their tax to the Roman government and by claiming that he is the Messiah, a king.
Are you the king of the Jews?
You have said so.
I have found no fault in this man.
But he is causing riots by his teaching wherever he goes. Yeah. All over Judea. Yeah. From Galilee to Jerusalem.
Yeah. Wait. You mean to tell me now that this man is a Galilean? Then enough has been said. For he is in Herod's jurisdiction. Send him to Herod and let Herod judge his fate.
We have already taken him to Herod. This rebel would not answer any of Herod's questions. Herod mocked and ridiculed him, commanding him to perform a miracle. But he would not answer. Herod dressed him like this and sent him to you.
Jesus. Jesus of Nazareth. Once you have been flogged, this rabble will see that you are merely a man.
My lord. A message from your wife.
Even her sleep is not safe from this Jesus. Her dreams are disturbed, but I cannot have all of Jerusalem in an uproar. Peace. It is peace that must be preserved at all costs. That is what Caesar would want. You have brought this man today to me, accusing him of leading a revolt. Now I have examined him on this point in your presence, and I have found him not guilty. Herod came to the same conclusion before he sent him to us. Nothing this man has done is deserving of the death penalty. So, I will have him flogged. And then I will have him released.
Where is he? Commander, am I too late? Marcus, where is he? Where is Jesus of Nazareth?
your message.
Why then? Why is he being flogged?
Claudia, please.
He is an innocent man. I would have testified to his character myself if you had given me the chance. Marcus, he has done no wrong.
Claudia, please. He is being flogged and then he will be released. Peace must be kept. This is a small price to pay for peace to be restored.
A small price? Easy for you to say. You give a command. Those men, they're whipping him within an inch of his life.
He brought this trouble on himself. Claudia, he is one man. One man. Surely a few drops spilled of one man's blood is better than the carnage of a revolt.
No. No, what if he is not just a man? What if he is exactly who he said he is?
Claudia.
The prophecies could be true.
His own temple leaders do not believe him. Why then, as a Roman, would you?
Marcus, I know this could be difficult for you to understand, but I have seen this God of miracles. I have heard him teach with my own ears. Once he spoke a parable of a sower and a seed. Not all the seeds that were sown grew, but some of them did. Marcus, there is good soil in my soul, and truth is growing there. I cannot deny my feelings.
And I cannot act on my wife's feelings alone.
This is innocent blood. This is innocent blood on your hands. Oh.
What do you charge this man with now?
We would not have brought him to you unless you were a criminal.
Then take him away and judge him by your own law.
Only the Romans are permitted to execute someone.
Are you the king of the Jews?
Is this your own question? Or did someone else tell you about me?
Am I a Jew? Your own people brought you here today for trial. Why? What have you done?
My kingdom is not of this world. If it were, my followers would fight to keep me from being handed over to the Jewish leaders. But my kingdom is not of this earth.
So you are a king then?
No! You say I am a king. Actually, I was born into this world to testify to the truth. All those who love me will recognize that what I say is truth.
What is truth? I have found no fault in this man. But you Jews have a custom of asking me to release one prisoner each year for Passover, yes? Would you like me to release this king of the Jews?
Yes!
We want Barabbas! We want Barabbas! We want Barabbas! We want Barabbas!
We want Barabbas!
We want Barabbas!
We want Barabbas!
We want Barabbas!
We want Barabbas! We want Barabbas!
We want Barabbas!
We want Barabbas!
We want Barabbas!
We want Barabbas!
Barabbas, you are hereby pardoned for all crimes against the Empire. I am bringing this man out before you now, but understand clearly that I find him not guilty.
Look, here is the man.
Away with him! Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify him!
Take him yourself and crucify him! I find him not guilty!
But I will, he ought to die because he called himself the Son of God!
Where are you from? Why won't you speak to me? Do you not know that I have the power to crucify or to release you?
No. You would have no power over me unless it were given to you from above. But the ones handing me over to you now, they have committed the greater sin.
This man has broken no Roman law. He should be released.
If you release this man, you are no friend of Caesar. Anyone who calls himself a king is a rebel against Caesar.
Look, here is your king.
Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify him!
What? Crucify your king?
We have no king but Caesar. We have no king but Caesar.
Silence! I have found no fault in this man! Take him yourself and crucify him! I find him not guilty, and his blood is on your hands!
We'll take it, Pilate. His blood be upon us and our children!
Claudia, please, do not follow them. Crucifixion is something you should never have to show.
Marcus, please, tell me there's something you can do for him now.
Failed him. You know him to be the God of miracles. Do you not wonder why he does not perform some miracle and deliver himself?
Oh, he could. Oh. Please tell me he will deliver himself. I couldn't bear it if this was the end for him.
No, Claudia. This is not the end, but he is not going to deliver himself. He is willfully allowing this to happen.
What? How could you possibly know something like that? Who would choose to die on a cross?
The Lamb of God. You remember that it is Passover.
Yes.
A spotless lamb must be sacrificed to make atonement for our sins. Long ago, the prophet Isaiah foretold of this exact moment. He wrote he was despised and rejected. A man of sorrows and acquainted with suffering. He was led as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers is silent, he opened not his mouth.
It is just as you said. Please tell me what it means.
He is willfully choosing to be that sacrifice for us. So that perfect blood that he sheds washes us clean so we can be with him for eternity.
But why? would he do that for his people? I heard them cry, "Crucify him!" It's because he loves us.
Our God loves us. He loves you. He loves you enough to die for you.
No. I am not worthy of his love, Sarah.
None of us are. And that is the miracle that we will see today. We will be given freely what we do not deserve and could never earn. He is hurt that we may be healed. Surely he has borne our grief and carried our sorrows. The chastisement of our peace is laid upon him, and by his stripes we are made healed. The man of many sorrows is perfect love.
Wrong. Lord, remember me this day when you return to your kingdom.
This is very important. I promise you, today you will be with me in paradise. Woman, behold your son. Son, behold your mother. My God. Why have you forsaken me? I thirst.
Of truth. It is finished! Father, into your hands I commit my spirit.
Man was the Son of God.
We must not weep so. I do not weep. How can I not weep? How can you? You have seen everything I have seen. He may look defeated now, but in 3 days, he will rise.
Lord. This Jew is requesting the body of Jesus of Nazareth.
The body? So soon?
Yes, sir. Truly, this man was something else. He was the Son of God.
You believe that? You're starting to sound like my wife. So he is dead. You, are you a friend of Jesus? Where were you 9 hours ago when the mob demanded his blood?
His follower, sir. He told us of truth.
Truth. I've been hearing a lot of this word lately. Jesus told me at his trial that those who are for truth are for him.
His kingdom is built upon truth. He said we must be born again to see it. Our hearts need to be made alive by his spirit.
Born again? Jesus' spirit? How much more of this nonsense must I hear today?
Please, sir. Sunset and the Passover will be here soon.
Guard, give this man his dead friend and king. What do you want?
That imposter Jesus spoke of something. He said he would come alive again.
So?
So the tomb must be guarded. His followers could take the body and spread the word of his resurrection.
Let me get this straight. You are now asking me to use Roman resources to guard your dead king until he rots. Oh, pardon me. You have no king but Caesar. That's what I've been hearing you say in events of late, is it not?
Just until Sunday. He said he would rise again on the third day.
Do you believe this man or not? You had him killed because you said he was a liar. And now that he's dead, you believe him?
We do not. But some of his followers do. If the disciples steal the body and spread the word of his supposed resurrection, you and I will be in bigger trouble than before.
Fine. Use the temple detail. Don't want this Jesus becoming more trouble to us dead than he was alive now, do we? But let's just make sure that he stays where he's lain. Guard, go to the grave. Place a seal there. Let it be known that anyone who messes with the tomb messes with Rome. Now get out of here. Don't you Jews have some feast to celebrate?
Thank you.
So I will never be His grace is my salvation, the gift of God, the work of Calvary. It is done, it is finished, Christ has won, He is risen, grace is here, love has triumphed over death forever.
Woman, why are you crying? Who are you looking for?
Gardner, sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I'll get him.
Mary.
Teacher.
Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet ascended to my Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them, I'm ascending to my Father and to your Father, to my God and to your God.
Jesus of Nazareth. He really is gone. I had hoped it would be true, but I dared not believe it until now. God of Israel, I do not know how your people pray to you, but I know you can hear me. And I know you see the real me. I do not understand your ways, but I know that every single thing went according to your plan. You came unto your people, and you finished your work. I only have one question. Is it for me? Do you love me so much that you would send your son as a sacrifice to pay for my sin? Lord, I want to believe. Is that enough? Something about this man, did you not? At ease, Commander.
He was the Son of God. None of those who were crucified died the way he died. The sky was dark. The earth shook. It's as if he had given himself to death. It's as if he had orders to do so.
She said his death was not the end. But if this is the end of his story, what on earth do we do now?
Are you lost? Who is it that you seek?
We're looking for Jesus of Nazareth. Have you seen him?
Lord!
Come to me. I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever lives and believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this?
I do.
Do you believe this?
I do.
Then truly, I say to all of you, whoever lives and believes in me shall never, ever die. I have come into this world as light, so that no one would ever live in darkness. For God so loved the world that he sent his one and only Son, that whoever lives and believes in him shall never, ever die. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that through him the world would be saved. Everyone who believes in him will be saved. Do you believe this?
What kind of king would choose to wear a crown that bleeds and scars to win by heart? What kind of man tells me I'm the reason he can stay inside the grave? You, is it you, standing here before my eyes? Every part of my heart cries, alive, alive.
Wow, that was amazing. Wow, that was amazing. Anu, come on over. Didn't he do a good job? Wow.
That was amazing.
I'm going to ask you tonight to shift a little bit. You've been participating by as spectators in a play that took us from the time Jesus was 12 years old through the cross and the resurrection. And I believe that during the play, God did some surgery in your heart, spoke to your heart. If you are an unbeliever, we understand you. I was an unbeliever at one time, and seeing a play, I would enjoy it and appreciate it. But it was God that worked in my heart to ask the question, is this true? Did it really happen? Was Christ the Son of God? Did he die on the cross for us? And then very importantly, was he raised from the dead? In the audience here, I think there are some unbelievers, and we challenge you tonight to say to Christ, I believe a little. I can come to you tonight and believe in you and trust you. The scripture says that if we receive him, to as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the children of God. Then I also think there are people here that are believers, but you've never really, maybe you go to a church and maybe you are a believer generally speaking, but just like in a marriage, when the two walk down the aisle and they make vows and make a decision, I will take you as my wife, I will take you as my husband. In a similar way, God is asking you to participate. Would you receive the Son of God? Would you come to Christ tonight and put your trust in him? Do it tonight. Say to Christ in your heart, just now. Maybe you did it in the play, but now is the time to say, I can do business with God and put my trust in Christ. Maybe you've never done that before. Tonight, do it. Don't wait. You might say, I'm not a religious person. We understand that also. But we're not talking about a religion. We are talking about coming to the person of Christ, believing in him personally. And Christ comes into your heart. You are born again. The Spirit of God comes into your life, and you walk by faith, and you get to know him. He is real. Yes, if you have a drug addiction, you have a problem with fear or sex or some identity issue of some kind, God loves you. God gave Christ so that your life would be new. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creation. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new. Because Christ was crucified for you and raised for you so you could walk in the newness of life. Romans 6 and verse 4. So I'd like you to make a decision tonight to put your trust in Christ, and I'd like you to raise your hand here in the auditorium if you are doing that. If you're saying yes to Christ, I believe in him, would you do that tonight? Would you just raise your hand and put it up in the air? Then for helping you in your faith, we have Bibles to give out freely here. I have one here, and this is a whole Bible for you for free if you would come down front And the ushers will come, these men carrying Bibles with them will give you a Bible. So will you come forward, please? And we'll, if you raise your hand, come on forward, and then we'll give you a Bible, and then we'll take you. Yes, come on. You're making that decision. God bless you. Yes. Someone else, come on forward. There we go. Yes, there we go. God bless you. If you go out this way, there we go. They'll give you a Bible. There you go. Beautiful. Beautiful. Lastly, there might be some believers here tonight, and the play spoke to your heart about how you're living your life. How you are living your life. We want to encourage you. We know that you can live your life victoriously in a holy way. The Spirit of God in your life, and I mean it real seriously, it's amazing. When you know in your heart you can live in this life. Maybe there's somebody here tonight and you're like the prodigal son who's gone far away in your heart. Can that happen, Anu?
Yes, it can, but there's always God.
Yeah. There's always God. There's always forgiveness. There's more forgiveness and more forgiveness. And there's power. There's a new way. It's the grace of God. The church is called Greater Grace. God gives grace and grace and grace. But this grace is also so that I can live a godly life with joy and peace and power in my life. Go to church on Easter morning. We have services here at 9 and at 11 in the morning and in the evening at 6:30. Go wherever God leads you. But go to church and have that as part of your life and be edified in your faith. And it grows on you. It grows in you. Your life is changed from faith to faith. Wow, we are excited here. The people that played here tonight, it was amazing. I saw the actors and actresses, and I was amazed. They not only can act, but they can sing. They can sing. I thought, whoa, wow, she can sing too. Okay. They are also from foreign countries, where we have sent missionaries to China and Hungary and Poland and Argentina, and students come here and study the Bible. These people on the stage are from Baltimore and here in the States and other countries because God is moving. And they are no different from you or I. They are no different from any of us here. Yes, you, even you, yes, all of us. And the issue is, be strong in the grace of God. Learn grace. Learn who God is. Embrace Him. The prodigal son comes home and he realizes it's party time with his dad because his dad is a good dad, a good God. God is a good God. And God cares about you. Don't live in the pigsty of sin. Find Christ, walk by faith, and discover the joy and the peace that comes from the resurrected living Christ who's at the right hand of the Father. If you would like some counseling, you can come forward also and go right out to the side there as you please. We're going to dismiss you in a second, but you may come forward, get a little advice or word of encouragement or a prayer. Come to church And keep coming and learning and learn your Bible and walk by faith. And you'll find that this God that was raised from the dead affects your life today in 2019. Amen. All right, would you all stand with me, please? Share a word with each other for a moment and just say, this is a great play, a good night. God bless you and happy Easter.